Hello non-stop learners, in this video we will take a quick overview of the adrenal gland. We will see its parts, the hormones secreted and their functions very briefly. Welcome back to nonstopneuron.com, where learning medical concepts is as easy as watching cartoons. Let's get started. The adrenal gland, as the name suggests, is positioned adrenal, that is, it lies close to the kidney. At the superior pole, to be more precise, there are two adrenal glands in our body, one lying above each kidney. Now let's see its parts. Broadly, the adrenal gland has an outer cortex and an inner medulla, which is the central part of the adrenal gland. The adrenal medulla contains chromaffin cells. They mainly produce adrenaline, also known as epinephrine, and variable amount of noradrenaline, which is also called norepinephrine. These are known as catecholamines. They serve to regulate the visceral functions of the body. Now let's talk about the adrenal cortex. It is divided into three different zones. The outermost zone is known as zona glomerulosa, the middle zone is zona fasciculata, and the innermost zone is known as zona reticularis, which lies near the junction of the cortex with the medulla. I used to remember these layers with mnemonic GFR, which stands for glomerular filtration rate. Here, from outside to inside, G is for glomerulosa, F is for fasciculata, and R is for reticularis. All the three cortical zones secrete different hormones which regulate various body functions. Glomerulosa layer secretes aldosterone, which regulates the blood pressure and electrolyte balance in the body. The aldosterone is considered a mineralocorticoid as it promotes salt and water retention by the kidney. Zona fasciculata forms 75% of the adrenal cortex. It principally secretes cortisol and corticosterone. They are the major endogenous corticosteroids and regulate metabolic pathways and immune system. They are considered glucocorticoids because they increase blood glucose levels and their deficiency causes hypoglycemia. The innermost reticularis layer secretes androgens such as dehydroepiandrosterone and its sulfated form DHEAS. They are sex hormones. Glucocorticoids, mineralocorticoids and sex steroids together are grouped under steroid hormones, and the process of their synthesis is known as steroidogenesis. So this was the cortex. Now let's have a quick summary. Adrenal gland is an endocrine gland located above each kidney. They have an outer cortex and an inner medulla. The medulla produces adrenaline and small amounts of noradrenaline. The adrenal cortex has three different zones which secrete different steroid hormones. Among them, aldosterone, the principal mineralocorticoid, and cortisol, the principal glucocorticoid, are of exceptional importance for the normal endocrine functions. In the upcoming videos, we will discuss in detail the synthesis and actions of these hormones. So stay tuned. That's it for this video. If you feel this video will help your friends and colleagues, please share it with them too. And don't forget to subscribe because lots more to come. At Nonstop Neuron, learning medical concepts is as easy as watching cartoons. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video.